you're moving to Nashville, Tennessee, you do know that Nashville is not the only place to live. You have a lot of selections when you're looking at moving to the Middle Tennessee area. If you're looking for family-friendly, beautiful lifestyle, four seasons, if you're looking for those things, you might want to check out the next place we're going. See you on the other side. Hey, on this show, Nashville Redefined, we do so many videos about what it's like to eat, sleep, work, play in the Nashville area. So if that's for you, be sure to go ahead and subscribe right down there. Tap the bell so you will be notified every single time we do a new video, which is every single week. You don't want to miss out. Truly, we have so many people calling us every day, moving to Nashville, wanting to know where are the best places to live, where is it like to live here, and I love it. If you're considering moving to Nashville, please send me an email. Call me. You've got that information right below. Send up smoke signals. I don't care. Whatever it takes to get in touch so that we can help you find the perfect situation for you and your family. My team and I have your back when you're moving to Nashville. Now let's go. Let's see the next place. And be sure to hang on to the very end because the most important part is going to be for you at the very end to help you out.
So many of you watching the show here at Nashville Redefined have been saying you would like to see some of the outlying areas around Nashville, some of the suburbs. Well, today we're going to go into one of the hottest areas that many people have been asking me about, and it's one of the hottest areas of growth right now, Spring Hill, Tennessee.
Spring Hill is known for its mix of old and new, and it's quite often just called a very quaint community. Spring Hill is a city in both Maury and Williamson County, so it straddles the line. It's approximately 30 miles south of Nashville, between Franklin and Columbia. It is included in the Nashville SMSA, so when I say Nashville, it's included. The population from 2019 is about 43,000, and that's up 6,000 from the year before. When we say we're growing, we mean it. What you'll see as you drive to Spring Hill is both farmland and then areas of development just across the street. You often also will find maybe a large farm where different family members have built their homes and they all come off of one driveway. You got a nice mix, which is why this is such a quaint community. You're going to find the rapidly expanding subdivisions and new communities sprinkled in amongst historic properties, Civil War battlefields, rich family farmland, and everything that someone needs to have a nice lifestyle in a smaller community close to downtown Nashville. As I mentioned, Spring Hill straddles the line between Maury County and Williamson County. It's on both areas. What you'll tend to find is homes a little more expensive on the Williamson County side than the Maury County side. That's just because of the stellar Williamson County schools, but Maury County schools are becoming competitive.
So today I'm here at Spring Hill High School, and one thing you will probably notice, as opposed to some of the other videos that I've done, of the shows that we've done regarding different Williamson County and Davidson County schools, is that the further out we go into a community where it is growing and thriving and new homes are being built, you're also getting a lot of new schools. As the new schools are being built, they're on much larger property. They have far more facilities that are really newer, that are state of the art, but they also are far more spread out than some of the other ones that I've done in previous videos. That gives you lots of space for tennis courts, baseball fields, the stadium that's behind me, enormous facilities here. As a community grows and as subdivisions are being brought in that are having 200, 300, 400 houses, then the need for that space and that size of the new schools just grows. That makes sense. But, you know, some of the other areas may not have the glamorous facilities that these newer schools have. Just something to think about when you're trying to decide which area you want to live in when you come to Nashville. The schools may not want me to tell you this, so don't tell them where you got it. But what better place is there to teach your children how to both ride their bike, ride their scooters, maybe even learn to parallel park than on the weekend in a big parking lot like this? Shh, you didn't hear it from me.
Let's do a drive-through of a development that is directly across the street from that new high school. What you'll see is smaller lot sizes and newer construction, newer styles. New communities all have sidewalks. They are on smaller lots, typically have an ARC or Architectural Review Committee. Typically one, if not two or three builders own the rights to building on the lots. So what you can possibly do is build a semi-custom home. In this area, there are no lots available. So what you would do is these would be home resales. These resales would compete with new construction homes. The new construction homes are generally much more expensive than resales. Oh, and by the way, I am definitely not driving this fast through the neighborhoods. Let's move over to a little bit older section of Spring Hill. And what you'll notice is a little bit older style homes, a little larger lots, no sidewalks. This is not a sidewalk community. And the overhead utility lines are there. Those are some of the differences you're going to find in older versus newer communities. You know, we have to talk about history. This is Homestead Manor. It was built in the early 1800s. It's actually on the border of Thompson Station and Spring Hill, so I got to show it to you. This is the site of Confederate and Union Army battle with Nathan Bedford Forrest in 1863. Hey, if you're enjoying these videos, getting a lot out of it, getting some great information, I sure would appreciate a thumbs up and go ahead and subscribe to this channel, because we go into different areas of town all over Middle Tennessee every single week. Now here we've got one more development. Remember, I've told you that Spring Hill straddles the Williamson County and the Maury County line. Homes in general are more expensive on the Williamson County side because of the good school districts. Here you're going to be on the Maury County side. This is a newer development, and these prices start mid-300s, but frankly, by the time people add some things that they always do to features on homes, those are going to go up into the more mid-fours. And here I've crossed into one more new development, a new community in the Maury County side. These prices run mid-500s to mid-$600,000 price point. So you're kind of across the board. Mid-3 to mid-7s is about what you're going to get across the gamut. New construction, old construction, Maury County versus Williamson County. There are a lot of nuances to the pricing of homes within this community.
So today we've been in Spring Hill, Tennessee. That is just about 30 miles south of downtown Nashville, 15 miles from Brentwood. And it's a perfect spot if you happen to work maybe in Franklin, over in Cool Springs with all the corporate headquarters, or even over at the Mars plant. So that's a group or spot, and you'll always be working kind of against traffic. Now, if you are the type of family or person thinking of moving to Nashville and you want a lot of light nightlife, if being around a big family community just feels a little bit more, it's not what you're looking for, that's not your thing, that's okay. That's why I'm here. I'm here to help you find the ideal location for what you're looking for when you're moving to Tennessee. But the only way I can help you do that is for you to reach out to me. Email, text, call me, do whatever it takes. Send up those smoke signals. You get the picture. Reach out to me. I don't bite, you can tell. Certainly not prim and proper and sophisticated. We're here to help you out.